Welcome to Real Life with Andrea. This is my third attempt this morning at a video. I have just been bombed this morning with phone call and text message and phone call and phone call and phone call. And so I haven't been able to get through a single thought process, which has left my mind scattered and wandering. But welcome to Real Life. Real Life can be a challenge, especially during this holiday season. Exception to that rule. I am a yes person. I say yes to way too many things, and that leaves my life being stressed and crazy. decision and the consequences will come. And now you're living in the midst of that idea that your choices are affecting your life, and this is going to have long-term ramifications. And how do I help that? Maybe I don't. I mean, maybe that's it. I think he's 18 years old. I've been trying to help him understand this concept. That was my job. Now he's an adult. Maybe those things just have to live themselves out. For example, we only have one car. So if he decides to get up and go to work, he can't because he has no ride. Well, I suppose he could Uber or taxi. He could spend the money on that. But reality for, will he? I don't know. So how do I let go of, and I know the technical steps of letting go, and I have to, but we have this in our heart. It still weighs heavy on me. When my son is doing things, and mostly because he lives at home and I see it every day, it weighs heavy on me when I see him doing things that are hurting himself. And that affects my ability to have my capacity in my mind with all these other things. Because as you get older, let's just be honest, we have less capacity to multitask, we have less capacity for having all these things in our brain, less capacity to compartmentalize. And so I'm finding that things are kind of all clumping together, and especially my 18-year-old, he is a special source of brain power right now. I love him. He is, has the potential for so much right now, not making the best of choices. And he looks at it as he's making better choices than his friends, and while those things may be true, let's not measure ourselves against our friends. That's never going to end well. Anyhow, so that this is my Saturday morning, my thoughts, my feelings about different things, and we're coming into Christmas in 2 days, and I'm not ready, but my kids will roll with it, and that I do appreciate, that there isn't emphasis on money and gift giving, because that is not what this day is all about. It's about putting others first. It's about thinking about the sacrifice, not the sacrifice, thinking about the birth of Jesus, and how this is the day that we celebrate, that God sent his son to redeem us. And let's be joyful about that, and not let the cares of this world or the culture of Christmas, the Santa Claus, the gift giving, the demandingness, the busyness, wreck our Christmas celebration. That's all I have for today. Thank you for listening. As usual, thumbs up the video if you liked it. Subscribe if you would like to. I thank you for watching and supporting my endeavors to just share my thoughts and feelings. I think that more people should share their thoughts and feelings, whether you have a large following, a small following, or no following. I think that this type of thing is therapeutic. Hear it yourself. Say what is on your mind. Helps, really does help to do a video vlog, whether you ever go back to listen to it or not. When I was in school and taking a communications class and talking about writing papers and writing stuff for communications, one of the steps was always read it out loud to yourself, because what you write and when you say it in your head sounds different than when you say it out loud, and that is so, so, so true. Now, when you get on platforms like this, you need to be respectful, you need to be, I think you need to not be swearing all over the place.